So you may be teaching from class to students at home. You may be teaching from class to students in class and students at home. You may be teaching from home to students at home, and you may be teaching from home to students in your classroom at home. Like, as an example, maybe you get quarantined, but you're still going to teach from home, but your students are still going to be in your classroom. So we're going to go into all those. All the charts that you're going to see that are my production team did a great job setting up, say, Zoom. But you could substitute Zoom for Google Meet, for Microsoft Teams, for Cisco WebEx, for whatever tool your district's using. All these great tips apply. So here's the first one we want to show you is you're teaching from a classroom to students at home. Now, yes, the webcam works, but if you can get a PTZ camera, and that's what we have set up over here, that's the PTZ camera that I'm on, you can really get a more engaging kind of classroom feel to what you're doing. So if you give us a second, Adam's going to take down the green screen, the virtual set now, so we can walk you through a little demo about what we're talking about for being at home. So let's take the green screen down. Cool. So the virtual sets are down. So let's say this is the webcam shot that I'm doing all day, and it's kind of, you know, not so great, kind of boring. Now I'm going to say, let's say you use the PTZ camera instead of the webcam. So let's cut to this camera where it's up here right now. And you can see this is a little bit different view. There's a little more of me. I'm not just a head. I'm a little more animated for the camera. But let me show you the real cool part of what you could do with this. And we're going to have this camera go to a different preset. And we're going to say, let's say I'm going to my chalkboard or my whiteboard. And let's do that. Oh, what do you know? We just happen to have a whiteboard right here that we're going to use for this demonstration. So now I'm here, and I'm just like I'm a normal teacher. So I'm going to say 4 times 4 = 16. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. We can go over anything we want to be teaching, but it's more like the environment that you're used to doing as a teacher with your board. And then you can always come back if you have the preset when you want to go here. And now, boom, I'm back talking this way. Or if I even want to go back to my Chromebook view, I can have that view that's more the talking head view. So we like doing that. We think it's a cool thing that you can do. And once again, let's go back to the, I'm going to clear this out. We're going to go back to the virtual set, and we'll be back in a quick second. All right, and we're back. So that was an example. So let's look at this one. Here I said if you're in a classroom, you could actually have three views. You could have the view of you. You could have the view with a whiteboard or a smart board, and then another wider view of another smart board. Or maybe that third smart board isn't a smart board. It's a human anatomy if you're a high school teacher teaching, you know, biology, or perhaps it's your lab stuff. Or if you're doing educational stuff that's mathematics, it could be some manipulatives or a board that's on there that's pre-done with words or language words if you were a teacher going over early reading and things like that. So here's the example of this classroom where I'm teaching in my classroom, but I'm teaching to remote kids, and how a PTZ camera can give me a more engaging lesson. And I can always bring up what I have on my own screen to share with the kids, and I can also put that on my smart board if I'm a school that has smart boards that work on my Chromebook. Next. Let's say you're in a classroom situation where you're going to have some kids in the class and some kids not. Well, here we're using the PTZ camera, and you can see I have those same three views, but I've added a fourth view. Now, can we bring that up full screen for a second? Which is, you know, the kids who are sitting, you know, socially distanced in the classroom. But now I just want to say something here. We understand privacy, and as being on a board of ed, I'm especially sensitive to privacy. So while we're showing that camera can show kids, that might not be allowed in your school. If you're going to get a PTZ camera to teach in your district, make sure you understand your district's privacy rules with regards to the students being on the screen or not. I think it's great to be able to show the kids, especially if you're having a class that's based on classroom discussions where the Zoom kids are coming and everyone's basically participating in the class as well. But a lot of schools have restrictions for students' privacy, and we respect that, and we get it, and we know it's a big deal. So don't do anything that's going to get you in trouble with your administrators or your community. Our next one is, let's say you're a teacher who has to teach from home. Maybe you've been exposed and you're quarantined from home, or maybe your district's saying you teach from home. Once again, I'm saying, don't just do that same boring setup that's just the Zoom camera. With a PTZ camera that's bringing us up full screen, you can do what I was showing, basically, where I can have this camera that's on me, and then I can have the other camera that's on me in front of my whiteboard or my manipulatives or my skeleton or whatever I want to be in front of. So it's just a way to bring it home and bring it to you. And then the last way is let's say you have to teach from home to students in a classroom at home. Well, that might happen. So maybe you're going to be at home, but now not only are you going to be Zooming to the kids at the Zoom, but maybe your district will have you zooming to the smart board that's in the front of your class. Now, I know this isn't ideal, but the truth of the matter is we see a lot of scenarios where a teacher could be forced to quarantine, or God forbid, you test positive but you're asymptomatic, where we still want you teaching, still want you working with the kids, but you got to do it from your home. There's technology here that can help you do it.
Thank you for watching this highlight from the Video Guys Live webinar. If you like this video or you want to learn more, check out the full webinar in our description, or head on over to videoguys.com for more information.